We're all in this together. A familiar statement at this time of crisis. A statement which calls us to look out for each other, to help each other, to work together. A statement which reminds us that none of us is 100% immune from this virus. At times like this, we often look out for assurance in our lives. The Christian gospel speaks about our assurance in Christ Jesus. The Bible tells us two rather disturbing and alarming facts. Firstly, that everyone is a rebel against the will of God, what the Bible calls a sinner. Christians refer to themselves as sinners saved by grace. The second alarming fact is that the Bible tells us that there's nothing we can do, there's no ability that we have that can guarantee us gaining assurance in Christ and eternal life with God. So how can, indeed can anyone, find this assurance, get this assurance? The Christian gospel says yes, but only in and through faith in Jesus the Christ, only in and through him alone. What does it mean when Christians say they're sinners saved by grace? It means that deep down they are exactly the same as everyone else, except that God has enabled them by his grace to accept the truth of what Jesus the Christ has done for them and to come to God in faith in Jesus the Christ. The Bible tells us that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. It also tells us that if we claim to be without sin, then we are deceiving ourselves, the truth is not in us, and in fact we are calling God a liar. On the positive side, the Bible tells us that it is by grace that we are saved through faith. This isn't something we do or earn, it is a gift from God. It also tells us that when we come to God in and through faith in Jesus the Christ, he sees us in Christ and that we are justified. That is, he knows that we have been sinners, but he treats us as if we had never sinned at all. Treats us in the same way as his sinless son. And if we confess our sins, then God is faithful and just and will forgive us our sin and purify us from all unrighteousness. Anyone who comes to God in faith in Jesus the Christ, confesses his sin, repents of his sin and invites Jesus into his life as Saviour and Lord, receives eternal life with God in and through Jesus the Christ. The same Jesus the Christ who said, "No one can come to the Father except through me." Yes, a Christian may sin from time to time, but through repentance that sin will be forgiven because of the blood that Christ shed on that cross at Calvary. The Bible tells us that without the shedding of blood there can be no forgiveness, and the only blood that counts in this matter is that blood that Christ shed at Calvary. People often accuse the Christian faith of being a dull, pressing, thou shalt not type faith. But actually, the Christian faith is one of joyful confidence in Jesus the Christ. It is, as the writer to the Hebrews puts it, being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see. Even as Christians go through trials of all kinds, be it lockdown, be it sufferings and grief caused by this virus, be it other illnesses or troubles, the certainty of their heavenly inheritance is solid and assured. Peter tells us in his letter that God is keeping in glory for each Christian an inheritance that will never perish, spoil or fade. Christian assurance is grounded in the purpose of God, in the saving work of Jesus Christ, and in the ministry of the Holy Spirit, against which nothing can prevail. As part of the body of Christ, the Church, Christians have God's affirmation of their salvation in Jesus the Christ. Day by day, sinners saved by grace are being transformed into the likeness of God through Jesus the Christ, being transformed into his likeness with ever-increasing glory. The very fact that Christians have God the Holy Spirit dwelling in them to remind them of the teachings of Jesus Christ and to be their advocate and counsellor and inspiration is further evidence of the assurance of their eternal salvation. Jesus said this, "My sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand. I and the Father are one." Shall we pray? Gracious and merciful and loving God, we come to you this day, acknowledging the wonder of yourself, your majesty, your splendour, your patience with us. Lord, we thank you for your wonderful invitation to come to you and receive assurance through Christ, to receive salvation for this life and the life to come. We thank you for the glorious promise that is awaiting for us in glory, that inheritance of which we have just spoken. Those of us who have accepted the truth of Christ's work for us, who moved by your grace and mercy and your Spirit have come to you in and through him, thank you and praise you that we know our eternal destiny is safe in your hands, and that we shall one day be in glory with you. Father, for those who have yet to accept this truth, for those who have yet to come to you in and through Christ, have yet to receive this wonderful assurance of eternal life, work in their lives by your Spirit. Draw them to yourselves. Assure them that all this applies to them as well. Bring them into your family, into your kingdom, where with us they shall be co-heirs with Christ. Father, to you alone be all honour and glory. In Jesus' name, amen.